I'm assuming you guys are going to want to be able to actually see what's in this tank.
It is a quarantine tank, though, however, so algae is not my concern. In fact, I welcome algae all over everything within a quarantine, simply because what does algae do? Helps remove nutrients from the tank, including nitrate, which is pretty important when you get new fish into your home aquarium. You do want to have water quality pretty optimal. But of course, for the purpose of this video, I'm going to clean it up a little bit. Plus, the fish don't mind eating it. Today, we're moving these festivums, which is a South American cichlid. Look how gorgeous and simple they are. Absolutely stunning. We'll talk more about them in a second. But they are going into this tank. Is this tank looking good? I just wish it was bigger. I wish it was like 5 times bigger. I think it's absolutely gorgeous. I love it. So simple, so effective. A few pieces of wood, some moss, some java fern, locally collected rocks, and some sand. This could be play sand for all you guys know. Definitely one of my favorite aquariums. As somebody that's obsessed with fish tanks, every new fish tank is always my favorite though. So, next one will be my favorite. The most important thing that I had to do during this entire process was the quarantine process. All fish need to be quarantined upon arrival. It doesn't matter where you got them from, how long you've had them, you know, what your past experiences have been, you've never had an issue, et cetera, et cetera, et cetera. It's gonna be that one time when you add fish to a big tank with existing fish and then all of a sudden you have an ick breakout. Now you look at these guys, they are in fantastic shape. There was a bit of an issue at first with adding so many fish to this tank, so I just jump-started it with the Fritz Turbo Start. It's just bacteria in a bottle. It actually does work really well. So that's the only thing in it besides using the SuperTech. Now, you guys have heard me talk about this in the past. This is really, really good for fungal bacterial infections, and these guys were a little banged up. I didn't lose any simply because I was able to stop any sort of secondary infection that would have happened because of the initial injuries that they did have, simply from shipping and whatnot, torn fins, ripped up bodies, a little bit scratches. But as you can see, even though they are tiny, every single one of them is in perfect shape, responding how I'd want them to, looking for food, actively coming to the front of the tank. And you know, I gotta credit SuperTech for doing that, of course. If you guys wanna get it, I'm in Canada, so we don't have medications. This is the closest thing that we have, and it actually works. So I'm gonna leave a link in the description below. If you guys want to get it. I've only been using it for a few months, but because of this, I haven't had any losses in quarantine since. Those festivums will eventually come into the 2,000-gallon aquarium. It will go in here with these archer fish. It'll go in with the severums, the angels, as well as the walru. But they're just too small to do so just yet, and right now it's just not going to be a good idea. It also has the denizen barbs as well as the tiger barbs, and then we have that sunshine pleckle that rarely comes out. Right there are some corydora in here now, like 50 of them, but you'll never see them until the evening, but we are adding another 50. Go figure though, the festivums do really well with walru, angels, as well as the severums, simply because they all come from the same area, have same diet requirements, water quality requirements, etc., etc., etc. So they're going to do absolutely fantastic in this tank, and they get relatively big. They'll get as big as the walru. But their body shapes and coloration do not change that much, as opposed to the severums, for example, or the walru that look nothing like they do when they're babies as they do now. So these guys, with that beautiful stripe right through their eye and up to their dorsal fin, will always have that. I'm not even focusing on them. I'm looking at the fish myself while you guys are forced to look through a camera that's not even pointed at them. But they're always going to look like this. They'll lose that barring along the side, but that's common in juvenile fish. You can really see it in this guy. It has to do with camouflage and blending into the surroundings, etc. Basically protects them from larger predators. Before I scoop those beautiful guys out, let's go take a look at a fish that you guys won't stop asking me about. Gotta go in the house. Woo, beautiful out. Absolutely stunning day outside, and I'm in the house making videos for you guys. Well, I'm lying. I was outside all day, and that's why this video's late. The Oscars, how are they doing? You guys ask me constantly. Look at the bottom of the tank. I just did a water change yesterday, and that's uneaten food. They're the messiest eaters of all. I feed them large food sticks like this, and they just go nuts for them. I just fed them earlier. I didn't know if I was going to be showing them or not, but anyways, these guys are doing great. Putting on some massive size. A little, whenever they're full and don't want to be bothered, they get like green as opposed to blacks. But definitely doing well. doubled, tripled in size since we've had them. Go figure, that's what the Oscars do. You'll also notice that the massive piece of wood's no longer in there. A couple of them, I just removed it like recently. This is an awfully dark tank, but a couple of them, for example, his head there, his forehead's got a scrape, but they're just getting too banged up on it. Every once in a while, they'll chase each other around and smash into that, so now it's just got a log in the back for, obviously they don't need it, but there you have it. Oscars are doing great. And then, of course, my nano tank down here in the podcast studio. Haven't been making podcasts lately. I'm about a week behind on that. You'll know why here shortly. I mean, it's all still here and it all still exists. I'm just not able to do one right now. Tamara's tank. Gorgeous. You guys love this. She knocked it out of the park. All you guys thought so. The lights on these tanks are a little yellow. But I think that has a lot to do with the tannins being released in this one. Because if we look at this one, it looks yellow. And we look at mine over there. Mine's not as yellow, but I still have wood in there releasing some tannins. Anyways, plants are doing well. I don't see any explosive growth, but that's not going to happen until I potentially add CO2 in here. But for now, it's keeping the plants alive and healthy. No algae issues, but again, there's no real nitrogen cycle going on in here besides plant foods being added. We have no fish in here just yet. Added no bacteria, but we will shortly. All right, fish are in the bucket right now. Removing 15 of them over here. That's ideal numbers for the 2000. With that said, no need to acclimate. The temperature of this water matches every aquarium in the gallery. The quality and the parameters or perimeters of whatever you want to call it, because I pronounce everything wrong, matches everything in the aquarium gallery, of course, besides the saltwater aquariums. So there's nothing to acclimate to. Essentially, they're just being netted and moved around. I think this is the best position for you guys to see this too. Come on, guys. Look at them go. They're so excited to be out. They're gonna love this tank too. Love it. This is the perfect tank for them, I swear. God, I love it. All right, there's a big one in here, and you don't want out. Two in this one, and then one more. Very simple tank. I mean, ideally we add in some small tetras and some Corydora, and we call this tank a day. I think that would be the perfect combination for this aquarium, especially just to grow out the festivums. Now, welcome to my aquarium where I just added the fish and all of them are hiding. Well, not all. Look how good he looks. Oh, that's one of the smallest ones too. Where'd you go? Look at him, just his head out. Aren't these just such a simple yet unique fish? Absolutely beautiful when they get older as well. They only get better with time. See? Just like I said, they're doing everything I wanted them to do, going up through these little cave systems we made during the scaping process. This is really, really well doing good. There's still blackbeard algae growing within the moss, but there's not enough nutrients in this tank to keep it going. So it'll die off and I'll just be able to siphon it out here eventually. But you can see with this sand, that's the downside with using a really fine sand, is it collects everything on top of it. It's all speckled. It's supposed to be like super clean, but it's all speckled because of the wood. But yeah, we'll give this tank a little while to kind of get established with these guys, wait until they're, you know, out and about constantly, and then we'll look at adding in more fish. I think we'll add more fish in maybe a week or so, a few days, I'm not sure. But yeah, this tank is by far right now, just based on the skate, my favorite aquarium out of all of them. I'm guessing it's your guys's too. But let me know in the comment section below if you like this tank or not. Everything's doing great. Anyways, guys, I have to get back to work on something really big. So I'll see you guys in the next video. Oh, don't forget, link to the SuperTech is in the description below. Pick up a bottle, add it to your medicine cabinet for your aquariums. This little bottle treats 1,800 liters. Nice. Oh, and if you keep wondering why I keep mentioning it, or, you know, Joey, it must be Joey's medication. It's not, 100% not mine. It's my local fish stores, One Fish, Two Fish. In Dartmouth, Nova Scotia, is the sole distributor of it or something like that. I don't know. Anyways, it's COVID. Califax went back into lockdown this week. He can only operate at like 20%, 10%, something 15, 25. I don't know what it is, but he's facing, you know, it's been a rough year and a lot of stores are closing. So what I'm trying to do is trying to get him to sell some of his stuff online, some of my favorite things that I use, so that he can keep his head above water until things get back to normal. So if you want to support a local fish store, again, link is in the description. And now you know why I talk about it.